Minerals are an essential raw material used in various industries. The extraction and use of minerals should be integrated with the economic development of the country. There should be rules governing the exploitation of minerals, and these rules should be dynamic with respect to the changing global economic environment. Hence, it is mandatory to state the various elements of the national mineral policy. Basic features. Detailed and scientific prospecting needs to be carried out in order to fully exploit mineral resources, using state-of-the-art technology and ensuring zero wastage. This requires large investments and a well-placed regulatory system to the effect that there should be transparency in the allocation of concessions. The Geological Survey of India, GSI, the Indian Bureau of Mines, IBM, and the state directorates of mining and geology will ensure the enforcement of mining plans, use of proper mining methods, and optimum utilization of minerals by way of strengthening manpower, technology, and skills. Mining activities have known to disturb the ecological balance. Hence, a plan for sustainable development will be devised to ensure that proper measures are taken to ensure that the biodiversity issues are taken care of, especially to protect the interest of the tribal population. There does exist a value addition link between the exploitation of minerals and its use in an industry. Therefore, employment and tertiary sector spin-offs should be encouraged to maximize their contribution of the mineral sector towards the country's gross domestic product. The end use and viability of an industry using the mineral depends on the infrastructure in use. Innovative structures will be devised for this purpose with encouragement of public-private partnership funding. The revenues from minerals shall be rationalized among the mineral-bearing states to protect their legitimate fiscal rights. In case of illegal mining, the concerned states shall be assisted with the financial and operational linkages of the Indian Bureau of Mines. Not only should research and development be given importance, but educational and training facilities for development of human resources should be given importance in order to ensure scientific and optimal mining. Regulation of minerals. Both the central government and the state governments are responsible for the management of resources as per the terms of Entry 54 of the Union List, List 1, and Entry 23 of the State List, List 2, of the 7th Schedule of the Constitution of India. The Mines and Minerals Development and Regulation Act 1957, MMDR Act, states the legal framework required for the regulation of mines and development of all minerals other than natural gas and petroleum. The central government has outlined the Mineral Concession Rules 1960 MCR for regulating grant of reconnaissance permits RP, prospecting licenses PL, and mining leases ML in respect of all minerals other than minor minerals and atomic minerals. The state governments have outlined the rules with respect to minor minerals. The central government has also outlined the Mineral Conservation and Development Rules 1988 MCDR for conservation and systematic development of minerals. These are applicable to all minerals except minor minerals, coal, and atomic minerals. The central government, in conference with state governments, shall frame the legal measures required to give effect to the new National Mineral Policy 2008 in order to ensure the elementary consistency in mineral administration across the country and to guarantee that the development of mineral resources is in league with the national policy goals. The MMDR Act, the MCR, and the MCDR shall be amended in the line with this policy. Both the central and the state governments shall be responsible for the pronouncement of the guidelines for mines and the development of mineral resources as in agreement with the national goals and policies as given by the legal framework of the nation. The procedures for grant of all types of mineral concessions, such as reckonance permits, prospecting licenses, and mining leases, shall be transparent and continuous with security of tenure guaranteed to the concessionaries. The selection criteria in the case of both the first-in-time sole applicants and multiple applicants shall be suitably explained. Prospecting and mining will be documented as independent operations with transferability of concessions, playing a vital role in the development of the mineral sector. Role of the state in mineral development. The Mines and Minerals Development and Regulation Act 1957 and rules made under the Act by the central government and the state governments state the various roles to be played by the central and state government, which are synced with the national mineral policy. The facilitation and regulation of exploration, mining activities of investors and entrepreneurs, provision of infrastructure and tax collection will be undertaken by the state. There shall be no link between state agencies that mine and those that explore. It is also mandated that the state and its agencies shall maintain transparency in all their functions. Survey and exploration. The Geological Survey of India is the primary agency for the geological mapping and assessment of regional mineral resources of the country. The Mineral Exploration Corporation, directorates of mining and geology of the state governments, and various central and state public sector organizations undertake the in-depth exploration on land. The private sector is where the funds would be forthcoming. Public funding is to be done in areas which lack private funding due to uncertainties. Large-scale prospecting license would be introduced to ensure large investments and high-end technology. The Ministry of Earth Sciences, MoEs, and its agencies are responsible for seabed exploration and mining. The mapping of the extended economic zone will be accelerated and accomplished within the time set by the International Sea Convention. The Central Programming Board of the Geological Survey of India coordinates the regional exploration of the mines. The disaggregated projects are discussed in the state-level committees and other nominal forums before being unified into the annual program. The arrangements shall be refurbished to ensure that projects are prioritized in line with the national policy goals and are drawn out after taking exploration work undertaken by the private sector into account. Database of mineral resources and tenements. The Geological Survey of India, the Indian Bureau of Mines, will maintain an updated and digitized database containing both a resource inventory and a tenement registry. The resource inventory will contain the latest version of the UNFC system displaying all the details regarding reserves. The tenement registry will give details of both the leasehold areas as well as freehold areas in terms of greenfield, brownfield, and abundant. The data is maintained online, giving prompt information to potential investors on what is available for exploration and mining. Strategy of mineral development. General strategy. The principle followed under general strategy is to give priority to import substitution, value addition, export, and most importantly, economic cost of recovery. Conservation and mineral development. Conservation of minerals shall be for the improvement and augmentation of the reserves through improved mining methods. Value addition by means of beneficiation, calibration, blending, sizing, concentration, palletization, purification, and general customization shall be encouraged. Scientific methods of mining. Mine development and mineral conservation as administered by the rules and regulations will be on scientific basis with the regulatory agencies, which is IBM and the state directorates, closely cooperating with R&D organization and scientific bodies to confirm optimum mining plans. Mining as an industry with linkages. Mining contributes to the generation of revenues and employment and is hence is a vital economic activity. In order to ensure unremitting supply of the mineral raw material from the source to the user industry, the industry will be stimulated to develop long-term linkages with the mineral producing units. Proper linkages are to be ensured in areas of production and marketing functions as well. Mining equipment and machinery. Indigenous industry for manufacture of mining equipment and machinery shall be strengthened. Induction of foreign technology and participation of this purpose will be encouraged. Use of equipment and machinery which improve the efficiency, productivity and economics of mining operations and safety and health of persons working in the mines and surrounding areas shall be encouraged. Manpower development. Facilities for basic and specialized training shall be upgraded continuously to ensure that effectively trained manpower is available at all levels for mining activities. Educational institutions will be also involved to provide these educational needs in the medium and long term. Infrastructure development. An aiding environment will be fashioned to stimulate large capacity mining companies to assume building of transportation networks, road and rail on their own. Public funding will be pumped into development of health, education, drinking water, road and other related facilities and infrastructure in mineral bearing areas to ensure the mineral development, regional development and the socio-economic welfare of the local and chiefly the tribal population. Financial support for mining. Mining is eligible to receive financial support from financial institutions. However, only those projects are financed which have credible mining machinery, equipment and buildings. Hence, options of segmented exchanges, foreign equity investment in joint ventures for exploration and mining promoted by Indian companies will be encouraged. Small deposits. Due to diseconomies of scale, small reserves of deposits can lead to suboptimal mining and biological imbalance. Efforts will be made to encourage mining of small deposits in a scientific and efficient manner while protecting the ecological economies of scale through grant of mineral concessions, where preference shall be given to scheduled tribes. Mineral development and production of environment. Mining activity habitually results in ecological problems like land degradation in open cast mining and land subsidence in underground mining. Deforestation, atmospheric pollution, pollution of rivers and streams, soil erosion due to disposal of solid wastes like overburden and so on, all affecting the environmental balance of the area. Prevention and mitigation, these ecological issues form an integral part of the mine development strategy. Mining activities shall not be taken up in ecologically delicate and biologically rich areas. Strip mining in forests should be sidestepped and it should be allowed only when supplemented with inclusive time-bound reclamation program. A mining lease would not be granted to any party who doesn't have a mining plan, which should include the environmental management plan approved and enforced by statutory authorities. Reclamation and afforestation will proceed alongside with mineral extraction as far as possible. Steps would be taken to convert old disused mining sites into forests and or other appropriate forms of land use. Mine closures. Once the economical extraction of a mine is complete, it shall be followed by scientific mine closure, which shall restore ecology, regenerate biomass, and take into consideration the socio-economic aspects of such closure. When mine closure becomes essential, it should be orderly, systematic, and planned in order to help the employees and the dependent community rehabilitate themselves without any unnecessary adversity. Mine safety. Mining activities are precarious in nature. Mining methods shall be devised and adopted which would escalate the safety of workers and lessen the occurrence of accidents. Foreign trade. Minerals are still an important source of foreign exchange earnings. The indigenous mineral industry should be adjusted to the global economic situation in order to obtain maximum advantage from foreign trade by expecting changes in technology and demand the global market for minerals. For the purpose of import, collaboration with countries with corresponding resource base shall be built for mutual advantage. To develop mining as a modern standalone industry, considerable investment is required. A key factor for investment decisions, particularly on FDI in the mining sector, will be on the export of minerals. Fiscal aspects. It will be the government's endeavor to design fiscal measures from time to time in the context of the national budget, changing national and international scenarios, favorable to the advancement of mineral exploration and development, including beneficiation and other forms of product refinement. Mineral pricing should be such that it reflects their true value, and the royalty structures will be designed to guarantee that the consumer pays and the producer earns the true value of the minerals. The fiscal privilege will aim to guarantee their suitable reimbursement and forthcoming to the state in return for the concessions granted by it. Research and development. General approach. Research and development in the mineral sector should encompass all the activities of mining. This includes finding new and alternative uses of minerals, development of correct technologies, improve efficiency in process and retrieval of byproducts, and reduce capital and energy requirements of the process. Research in mining methods. Rock mechanics, ground control, mine design engineering, equipment deployment and maintenance, energy conservation, environmental protection, safety of operations and human engineering shall receive special importance from the R&D department. Mineral processing and beneficiation. R&D efforts shall be concentrated in beneficiation and agglomeration techniques in order to put to use lower grade and finer size materials. Research organizations, including the National Mineral Processing Laboratories of the Indian Bureau of Mines, shall be made stronger for the development of processes for beneficiation and mineral and element analysis of ores and ore dressing products. Development of automated equipment. To ensure safe and economic production, attention will be given to the development of robotics, automated equipment and system for mining, particularly for deep mining and transportation to surface. Deep sea mining. Integrated systems for exploration, exploitation, mining and processing of resources shall be furthered with the development attainment of required technologies. Suitable mechanism for managing the survey and exploration of deep sea bed area shall be set up by the Ministry of Earth Sciences. Production of materials of high purity. There will be a thrust of R&D efforts of raw materials used required in the production of materials of high purity for use in advanced technology applications such as semiconductors, photovoltaic lasers, special sensors, high temperature new ceramics, hard and high temperature materials, superconductors, insulators, very thin films, glasses, and liquid crystals and metal and mineral fibers. Coordination of research organizations. Various resources and expertise available across all the R&D organization need to be pooled in order to meet the challenges in the mineral sector. Exchange of scientists between institutions shall be encouraged to quicken the pace of collaboration. Research findings will also be made available to users in an expeditious manner. There shall be a single and unified R&D and training institution of excellence to be known as the National Institute of Mineral Development for the varied research, development and training enterprises within the public domain. Organizations such as the National Mineral Processing Laboratories of the Indian Bureau of Mines, the National Institute of Rock Mechanics, the Jawaharlal National Institute of Aluminium Research and Development, the R&D initiatives of Geological Survey of India will be combined to provide a collective thrust. Impact of illegal mining. A regulatory step in order to curb illegal mining in the country through the financial and operational aid of the Indian Bureau of Mines. Also, provision of suitable relief and rehabilitation packages will be awarded to those whose belongings have been acquired due to mining operations. This involves the impact on the affected parties, and a mechanism shall be devised to improve their standard of living. For this purpose, National Rehabilitation and Resettlement Policy or any other revised policy or statute that may come into action will be followed. For the indigenous or the tribal population, the framework will incorporate the models of stakeholder interest for these population in the mining operation. However, at the present, the National Mineral Policy doesn't provide for any stringent action against illegal mining, and there is no proposal to amend the bill for the same. But the government has passed the MMDR, Mines and Minerals, Development and Regulation Bill in the Lok Sabha as of the 12th of December 2011, which has the following provisions. For all exploration activities, suitable compensation shall be payable to the person or family holding occupation or usufruct or traditional rights on the area of exploration. All mining leaseholders to pay annually into District Mineral Foundation, DMF, a sum equivalent to royalty in case of major minerals other than coal, and some equivalent to 26% of profit in case of coal minerals, and in case of minor minerals, a sum prescribed by the state government, since royalty for minor minerals are set by states and vary from state to state, will be payable to DMF. A portion of the amount paid into the DMF by the leaseholders will be used partly to making recurring payments to people affected by mining related operations. Mining companies allot at least one share at par to each person of the family affected by mining. Mining companies provide employment or rather compensation as stipulated under R&R policy. After mining is complete, mining companies need to pay for damages, if any, to affected persons as part of the mine closure and restoration process. Grant of mineral concessions in 5th and 6th schedule areas requires consultation with Gram Sabha, District Council in terms of any process defined under PESA, Panchayat's Extension to Scheduled Areas Act 1996. In 5th and 6th schedule areas, state may give preference in grant of mineral concession to a cooperative of scheduled tribes. It empowers the central government to intervene in the cases of illegal mining where the concerned state government fails to take action against illegal mining. The central government may issue general directions to the state governments or the National Mining Regulatory Authority for inter alia to detect, prevent, and prosecute cases of illegal mining. The National Mining Regulatory Authority may, in case of a written complaint, allege illegal mining in respect of major minerals on a large scale or organized or interstate basis, may cause investigation and prosecution. It ensures speedier disposal of application for mineral concessions with recourse to tribunal for delays. Every lessee, trader, stockist, and exporter to register himself with the IBM to facilitate an online ore accounting system. Currently, this process has been started by amending Rule 45 of the Mineral Conservation and Development Rules, 1988, Wide Notification, GSR 75E, dated 9/2/2011, making it mandatory for all miners, traders, stockists, exporters, and end users to register with the Indian Bureau of Mines and report on movement of minerals to Indian Bureau of Mines and state government. Such end-to-end accounting will reduce the scope for transportation illegally mines, minerals, including export of iron ore. Existing concessions would be cancelled for those persons convicted of illegal mining and debarred from future concessions. Data relating to grant of concessions will be placed on the official website. This will include geospatial data based on the cadastral land records data as well as GPS coordinates of the lease boundaries. Since minimum area for a lease will be 10 hectare, it will be feasible to do GPS in areas not fully delineated in cadastral maps, being forest areas, etc. Whistleblowing on illegal mining is recognized under the draft MMDR bill, and state cess can be used to reward whistleblowers. Conclusion. Mineral wealth is finite and non-renewable, yet it is a major resource for development. The need of the hour is for a well-planned program of survey and exploration, administration of all resources, those which have been discovered and those which are yet to be discovered. The optimal, economical, and timely use of minerals is a matter of national importance. The feat of the second national mineral policy will largely depend on the national unanimity to realize its fundamental doctrines and objectives.